Hey, sorry, I'm gonna keep the mute readily available, because, you know, baby and stuff. I'm sure you can hear him in the background.
Yeah, I can hear him being all fussy.
How come no one's talking in the chat thingy?
I don't know, they might be logged on, but just not here yet.
Are you ready, my brother?
Am I ready? Really? Hold on. That's retarded. Hold on. Settings.
What's retarded?
I can't click on Balshazar. Wait, hold on. Don't lock the taskbar. Nope, that's not doing anything.
Click on him like his character.
No, no, okay. At the bottom where it says as, I can't click Balshazar. It's...
Oh, yeah.
Go, Lily.
You can edit him and everything, right?
I mean, there's no token on the map, but... No, no, yeah, Ben, no, it's my computer's not letting me click underneath the drop down.
Gotcha.
I'm trying to find out why.
Hello.
Hey, is that Jake? Nope, it's Casey. Hey, Casey.
That's... Hey.
All right.
So.
Matt,
8 o'clock.
A minor technical issue. It won't let him. It won't let him, you know, click the little drop down to change who he's speaking as.
Really?
Or it's not that, it's that his computer, I don't know how his desktop's set up, or, but it's like cutting off the very bottom or something, I don't know.
It fixed it.
Okay, good. Jake! Are you here, Jake? I see it says Jake is in the call. But where is Jake?
Oh, not with Mick.
Not with Mike. Oh, is Yoshi in the call now, or is he also not with the mic? Because I see him peeking there. Go peek. That's fine. No mic is fine. Yeah, that's all good. Alright, I presume everyone is ready then.
Yes.
Or as ready as we will be. Find yourselves, for whatever reason, in the warm, lush continent of Kabara. The weather is, of course, dry, humid. It's hard not to run into more than one or two pests of varying varieties, usually insects, but more than one instance have had you nearly bitten by a seemingly random snake just crawling along like it's nothing. Though today, however, you find yourselves in a tavern. Yes, you are in a tavern.
Holy shit, it looked like that fish had legs.
Yeah, it did.
The tavern is far more warm and inviting than the lush jungle outside, filled with life. In here, on the other hand, the place is fairly empty, actually. There's hardly even sight of a barkeep or even a barmaid. There is but a few individuals sitting at a table, and they appear to be well-dressed, hoods up, and they're beckoning you to their table.
Beckoning who?
You guys. Wherever you are, however you are in the tavern.
I guess I go then. No other choice.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Tavern,
but were,
I mean.
Yeah. Forget this tavern. Screw the story plot. I'm gonna go over here and do this thing.
Where is the nearest lizard brothel?
The nearest. Well then. probably further down.
All right. Well then, we gotta keep going.
The city of New Throne is not known for lizard brothels.
That's bullshit. Let's keep going then. I go to the table.
Right, yeah. Balthazar leads.
You actually recognize the faces as you approach and you peer beneath the hoods. At least one of them. One of them is indeed a dragonborn. Balthazar, you recognize him as Kalataka. He looks around and asks you, are they use the companions that you've been gathering with you? And he peers over at your lizard folk and whoever else happens to be with you.
War is silently just following Bazaar like a stoic guardian of the innocent.
His glances over at the feline companion and kind of raises an eyebrow, but dismisses it otherwise. He replies to your comment. Indeed, times are pressing. Have only another 5 years before the next war, and at that time, we need you to be ready. You know it, I know it. But we must start small. I have done research. Closest and probably easiest tribe to deal with are with you about a day's walk north, west, and towards the south. The Burning Blood tribe to the south. They're not exactly forgiving and inviting people. They're known for their magic and power. I advise you to go, if you choose to follow up on them, bring an offering. The Fangwielder tribe to the north are much more acclimated to the recent interlopers, he says as he looks over at some of his companions who are, now that you're over there, both human. They do not mind trade and go to them and speak. and you will not be shot down. See what they need, and if you can earn their favor, then do so. The final tribe are the Tuk-Tuks. They are likely the most valuable tribe of all. Kalataga leans in close to Belshazzar and the rest of you, if you also lean in, and whispers, "They have a dragon shard mine. They don't like to advertise that they have it, but much of their days are spent tinking away at the dirt. For each new day brings them new shards, and shards will be something your army can desperately use when you've built it." Beyond that, I cannot say what else lies beyond. At this point, one of the other humans pipes up. "Well, if that's not what you're interested in, we could always use your help improving the relations with the Lizardfolk tribe. There's a tribe that lives in a cobbled together series of rafts south of New Throne, like far south. You'd have to take a boat to get there. They have all but abandoned dry land. And they bring in significant fish. But terms have been... relations have been rather strained lately. We haven't just quite seen eye to eye."
"What do you mean by haven't seen eye to eye?"
"They feel resentful that they've been forced to go to the ocean. We tried to negotiate, but they had been on some kind of pilgrimage, and when they'd returned, all of New Throne had been built.
Do we know where their pilgrimage was to?"
"I cannot say. I only know that they have long since been gone. But if you could recruit them to your cause and, you know, get us back on good relations, they could easily provide a food supply for your growing army."
Belshazzar nods, hearing all this information.
The fellow is still quiet, but you go ahead.
No, I wasn't going to say anything important.
Oh, okay. So, now that you've got all that in the quiet tavern, though it is the middle of the day and the shutters are all shut, what do you do?
What do we do?
Yeah, what are you going to do?
Is there booze? No, I'm just kidding. The easiest group to impress would probably be the ones to the north, I think you said, were the trade folk. The really just commoners, I guess. Right?
I think so. That was the... Did I say it was the Fang Wielders or the Tuk-Tuks?
Tuk-Tuks was the last one you mentioned.
Yeah, Tuk-Tuks was the one with the dragon shards.
Yeah, the Fang Wielders are the most open to trade and negotiation. They're the most peaceful, so far as you know.
So should we just go with easiest first?
That's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking go with the easiest, well, quote-unquote easiest. Since they're peaceful, they're not going to be as willing to join in the fight, but we're not needing them necessarily right now for help in the war. We're going to more or less try and help their economy out so that they'll help us when we need the help the most.
Do those lizard folk that have the rafts, what's their opinion on other lizard folk in Dragonborn, though?
They seem more... But as far as you're aware, they seem more... like, just in general, they would be more inclined to listen to Dragonborn and another lizard folk rather than humans who have been colonizing this area.
And the other person we have is a robot and a cat, so I don't think they're going to be too threatened by us.
But here's the issue. How do we get to them?
How do you get to them? That's a very good question.
We don't have a boat.
Well, you don't have a boat, no, but... This is the city of the throne. There's boats.
I'm resistant to fire, not drowning. You shut your meowth. I am threatening.
So what'll it be?
A water wagon. Man, I've already got a land wagon, so...
I'm assuming my character doesn't know what the word wagon means, though. So let's just go with water wagon.
It makes sense.
Eventually, war will be...
I obviously mean boat by that, Ben.
Do what?
Eventually, war will be able to build us a folding boat, eventually. But that'll take several levels.
Is a folding boat big enough to hold four people? I thought that was only two.
A what boat?
Folding boat.
A folding boat?
Yeah.
I mean, it'd be easier for us just to go chop a tree down and make canoes.
Can they supply us with a boat of any kind, Ben, or are we just shit out of luck?
No, they say that they could supply you with a boat. That's what the last guy is there for. He actually reveals he takes down his hood and says... If you're off to see the lizard folk, then I'm your fellow. He's a blonde male. Once you see him unveil his hood, though you previously thought he was human, he actually appears to be half-elf.
Even better.
To his skin seems to indicate that he is elven half is aquatic elf.
So he's like a quarter mermaid.
He says to you, though... They may be due for a shipment in soon. If you want to try and negotiate with them directly, you may. But I have a boat, and I could take us right now.
How long is their next shipment?
About half a day.
So what you think, Matt? Lizards or traitors?
Let's see. Well, if we go with the kobolds, the traders, we'll have a wider... Well, I mean, this could go either way, because if we go to the traders first and get them on our side, we could then go to the lizard folk and be like, hey, we have this whole settlement over here of trading kobolds and whatever to help sell your fish, so that's more money your way. Or we could go to the lizards first and... If we
supply them with fish.
Yes, yeah. And then, but if we go to the lizards first, we can be like, hey, you know, get them on our side. Then we can go to the kobolds and be like, well, we've got this supply of fish that can come in your way and make more money for you. So it's either way, we have to get one on our side first, or we could just go in there instead and be like, look, we've already got this. If you say yes, they say yes. And try and... But yeah, so...
You sound like you're a little more intent on the kobolds, I think.
I mean, either way works for me. It entirely just depends, because both the kobold, the northern kobolds, whichever clan that was, and the lizard folk to the south, or wherever, they both would play off each other really well. So, if we could win over either one, I think... for a war, I don't know, Jake, what do you think?
I mean,
what's everyone else think also? I mean, it's not just about me.
So what do the kobolds think about us? Like, what would they think about a cat, a robot, and a lizard and a dragon coming into their area?
It depends on which tribe you go to. The Fang Wielders, the ones most open to trade, if you can come, they'll let you come and go as long as you don't appear to be too threatening.
How about which one is closest to us? Which one would be the quickest path? Where would we get to quickest?
Quickest would probably be the Fang Wielders.
Alright, you want to just go those, Matt?
Is that the kobolds? Yeah, sure, we can go to that.
What do you think, Casey?
Yeah.
That'll work.
Alright, everyone load up in my wagon, let's go.
Alright.
Is there any objections?
Captain, you got anything?
Can I eat the spider that Al and I is looking at? Al, I don't know how to pronounce it.
We'll just call her Al.
Okay, yeah.
Or how about Allie? Because Al,
what would I roll to eat Allie the spider she's looking at?
There's no need to roll. You can just snap up that spider.
Okay, I
eat your tongue?
Spider.
Are you like a chameleon? Do not eat my spider, friend.
No, it's too late now. You ate it.
Yeah, I eat the spider.
You eat the spider. It's a little musty, but it's a spider. That's one more spider you've eaten that you don't have you don't have to worry about it anymore. Were you going to eat that?
So what kind of shops can we find in this town before we leave, though?
I'm broke as balls.
The town of New Throne, or the city of New Throne, is completely decked out in all the refinery, in all the finery that you could have anywhere else in Corvair. It has every modern amenity that you need. You need weapons, they got some decent weapons. You need a ride, they got a ride, they got animals. You know, just food, anything you could possibly need for adventuring is here.
Okay. I'm drawing a blank. I was going to buy something. Yeah, I forgot. Fuck it. I don't remember.
You going to buy a boat?
I mean, I've got a decent amount of gold.
Oh, no. Boats are like several thousand for a good one that could carry us all.
Ben, let me take the gold from my armor, since I'm a lizard and can't wear armor.
I'm part dragon and I can wear armor.
Well, I don't wear armor by choice, I guess. Alright, let's just
I have
leave,
a shield. What are you talking about? No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, let's head out somewhere. Whichever way.
I don't remember what I was going to buy. Maybe a bag of mice.
Well, that's certainly available.
All right, how much would a bag of mice be to carry with me as snacks?
We'll say, one silver. They are, like, specially cooked mice.
Oh, I wanted live mice.
Oh, you wanted live mice?
Yes.
About 50 copper. For, like, one really... It's like a travel bag of dead mice. For you to just eat.
He wanted
so
live mice.
Is five silver,
mice,
right?
Mice. They're live mice. So you buy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wait.
You go out.
Does
you find a.
Does war wear armor?
Do what?
Does war wear armor?
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Does anyone actually wearing armor right now?
Any of us have armor?
War might be wearing armor. He's a war.
I have a shield, and that's it.
Like. Who needs armor when we can just, like, fucking run around and kill shit without it? Alright.
Scales and whatnot.
I am spending 50 copper. That is, 5 silver total, right?
Yeah. I totally forgot to record how much gold I had after all this.
Okay. I have my bag of mice, and I am set to go. Let's go.
Alright. So which way were you going, north or south?
I'd say let's go for the kobolds first.
Yeah, let's go with them. And plus, then we'll have an army, or, well, a backing of kobolds. Who doesn't like kobolds?
Alright. You begin your journey. It's about a day's travel northward. You know, just riding in your cart.
It's a wagon, thank you.
Your wagon. Trying to avoid the hodgepodge of mud and waterways and all that. It takes a bit. And as you're rolling along...
Gotta say, a warforge wearing leather armor really terrifies me. Like the fact that it's just wearing the skin of something dead, yet it's metal. It's just...
And like a Terminator?
Unsettling.
Anyway. You're random encounter time. Forests. You hear birds chirping, making an awful racket. The tropical kind, of course. Not anything, you know, pleasant. You'll see an occasional monkey swinging through a tree. Usually its short little adventure is ended by a snake suddenly lunging out from some bush to snap it up.
There are a lot of snakes here.
Oh yes, there are quite a few snakes. You drive along until finally you reach an open area relatively free of the water permeating the area. It's fairly dry, it's very, very lush. There are quite a few plants, it's almost hard to see the trail. But as you approach, you see a large den of kobolds. And the first thing you note about all of their structures is that there are teeth attached to the ends of them.
You said teeth?
Yeah, like sharp teeth attached to the ends of them. You know, basically, like if a wall were to get, if a, like a big wooden wall of theirs were to get knocked over, you could just pick one of the slats up and it would be a makeshift spear just right there ready.
Sweet.
Fascinating.
While you're observing all this, roll an arcana check. Whoever cares to do so.
Accessing.
Woo! That had a 7 for an arcana.
You know what? Let's see. Where is my arcana at?
What's your intelligence, man? Is it 8?
It's 0. It's 10. I have 3 tens.
Wargun has analysis program at maximum power, scanning.
Yeah, you glance around, and you almost immediately can identify not only what kind of creatures these teeth came from, which are dragons, but what color dragon, just based off a couple of glances. And it looks like these kobolds have been collecting teeth from dragons for a very long time, because there are a lot of walls and just teeth. You approach, and there are two guards standing at the front of a wooden opening that lead into their village. They both hold spears, and like everything else, they are tipped with dragon teeth. They kind of cock their little heads at you and ask, in reasonably good common, "Who are you? What are you here for?" They kind of look you up and down suspiciously. Who approaches them first?
I do. I get down and walk towards them. "Hail, kin folk. I am Belshazzar of the..." Fuck, what I say his last name was? Nukabaran clans. "We mean no harm. We wish to set up a possible trade agreement."
They both look to each other. Well, you will wish to speak to the chief, they say. We cannot speak for the tribe ourselves. But very well, come along, and we shall escort you to him. And they look at the they look at the cat and the warforged with the most suspicion. But as long as they see, as long as the two of them are standing fairly close to Belshazzar and
Yoru,
the lizard.
Then they don't have too much problem with them.
War follows silently.
I'd like to offer the kobolds a mouse.
That's smart.
Alright. One of them looks up at you, kind of gives you a strange, toothy smile, as best as a kobold can manage, and they, you know, they partake. They're like, oh, thank you, and they dangle
I give
the mouse
him,
over their...
Yeah, I give him a live mouse, alright. Yeah. That sounds
they
fun.
Dangle the mouse over their open jaws, and then snap them up.
I'm just picturing midgets with crocodile heads.
Eating live mice.
Just like a bunch of little kids running around with giant crocodile heads on. That's all. That's all they are.
And as they lead you over, they stop at the largest tent, roughly towards the upper middle of the tribe. The tribe is a very circular, you know, behind its walls. There are scattered tents all about. A few workplaces. Mostly people dipping out piles of teeth to be attached to spears, basically. People preparing fish and other things. However, the chief's tent, the largest tent, is blue and has yellow strange markings on it. They
is it
away and it, the flat oh. entrance and beckon you in.
Belshazzar, I'm assuming, has to crouch pretty much all the way on his hands and knees to get in.
Yeah, basically. It's a very small opening.
Is there a way to determine what the markings are? Or are they not important?
Roll Arcana again.
Oh, damn it.
Ooh. Too concerned about trying not to fall over going in this tent. How am I gonna get in there? Ugh.
Does Belshazzar just say, like, yeah, those are markings?
Yeah, it's yellow.
And we're like, okay.
What language is it, Ben? Or is it a language?
Not in any specific language. It's some sort of runes that protect against lightning.
You're weird.
I didn't know. Yeah, you're, let's see. Allie actually knows the most about them. She guesses roughly that if there was a big storm that were to come in, that the chief's tent would not only draw in lightning, but use it for some other. It would store it and use it for some other purpose.
Protecting they have the a rest battery generator.
Yeah, protecting the rest of the tribe from, you know, lightning.
Basically, it's a giant lightning rod. Hmm.
Yeah.
Fascinating.
You see one blue kobold with a particularly sharp point on the end of his nose. He turns to you, dressed in more blue, dyed blue cloaks and, you know, things like that, and looks at you strangely. He replies to Allie, indeed, we call upon the lightning, as do the dragons of blue skin and storm. I am Blue Fang. What brings you to our tribe today? He kind of looks at you, not so much with suspicion, but with a little bit of eagerness, actually. Like, oh, you're, as if to say, you got anything interesting on you? He's looking mostly at your position, at your possessions, you know, kind of trying to peek around you and at your bags.
So he does not need my bag of mice. He's more interested in non-food items, I'm guessing?
You could.
I don't really have anything to offer.
Do you tell him that?
I offer him a mouse, I guess. I don't really have anything else.
He takes his staff, which is tipped with a particularly large fang, waves it around a bit, and zaps the little mouse that's on it. And it's fried, and he picks it up and eats it.
All right, so what's his name? Blue, whatever, Blue Fang?
Blue Fang.
Chief Blue Fang, the reason we're here. First off, I'm Belshazzar, hailing from Karashan. And as you probably know, we have a ritual war that has just ended and another one approaching in 5 years. We need as much help as we can get in this next war.
He looks at you strangely and says, I have not been to the ritual wars of Karashan for some time. And now here an invitation stands before me. But what sort of invitation is this? You say you wish us to join you in the fight.
We wish you to join us in any way you can.
Well, what we have are largely weapons. We of the dragon, or we of the fang wielders, are immensely fascinated by a dragon's teeth. Natural knives, resistant to flames, stronger than steel. They are indeed fantastic weapons. But we could perhaps supply a few soldiers. But in return, it would require more teeth. Bring us an entire maw of a dragon.
Oh, Lord.
We will supply you with weapons from its teeth and a number of good kobold soldiers to aid in your army. The type of dragon does not matter, though younger dragons are, as we consider them, still teething. Their teeth are not fully developed yet.
What is the age that you would require for us to bring you?
Full-grown dragon, I doubt you would be able to vanquish.
But that was my point.
Lesser dragons, drakes, wyverns, the like. They can be found hidden throughout the jungle. Tracking them would be a task in and of itself. Are you up to such a thing? He looks at you.
I look at the rest of the group. I'm down for it.
I will follow you. It is my order.
He's got a point. Allie? That's all four of us then. Balthazar turns back around to the chief. Where do we begin?
He replies to you, up the river. There have been rumors of a drake swimming about. We have not gone for it, because we have not finished our most recent kill. One of the wooden drakes. Some sort of half-green dragon drake of some... I have not seen many before. But the one you are after is further up the river. Are you up for the task?
Balthazar nods. We will depart at once. Or in the morning, whenever it would be easiest.
Well, you've been traveling for a while, so you may want to, you know, just...
Wait the night.
Wait the night.
Chief, if you would grant us a place to stay for the night, or even just let us park our wagon in your walls, we will set out in the morning.
Very well. You may do so. And he claps his hands. And a couple of the kobold guards come in, and they're followed by a few others who, you know, kind of escort you to some tents that are being set up and ready. And the night goes on, and you, just from kind of milling about, you observe these kobolds, and they industriously just keep at their work. They have little shifts. They exchange jobs every once in a while. They're mostly yanking teeth out of jawbones and carcasses and things like that, adding them off into a pile, and then the rest of the kobolds work to tie it to a spear and jam it into the ground, observe it, give it a good jab in the air, and then they set it on a rack. The night goes on, and nothing too special happens. The dawn approaches, and with it, the river is ready for your ride. Will you depart now?
Sure. Would the wagon be best to bring with us, or leave here? Like, is there a path leading up that way, or...
Yeah, you look up from, as you're, you know, getting up in the morning, you look around at the river, and it's fairly dense with foliage and the like along both sides of the river. So even if you were to get it to the other side, it would be hard to drive it across. So you would be best on foot.
What about a raft of any kind? Well, I can't drive a raft, never mind.
I mean, you could try to drive a raft.
I could try.
You just wouldn't be very good at it.
It wouldn't be, you know.
Allie, if you're doing that, roll investigation. You see that someone might have been tempted to take one of your things, but they did not, because they are not dragon fangs. In non-dragon fangs.
I mean, you are a cat.
Yeah, you've got all...
Balthazar would have more to worry about.
They're in your mouth, and whatever fangs you happen to have on your person, they are there.
Well, Balthazar stretches, gets a good... sweat pumping, getting his blood going, and he's ready to go. Looks to the rest of the group. Well, I'm packed. Anyone need to do anything before we go?
Negative. Ready to move out.
Allie? Yoru?
Thank you.
That is only in theater.
All right, well then let's start heading out. Balthazar. You. I'll get you some in a second, Lily, okay?
One second, let me get you all set up.
Theater people and data unknown to Alani.
Theater humans are quite strange in their sayings.
Indeed.
I'm assuming we're not going to actually break each other's legs, so let's get going.
Yeah, no, yes. I'm not. Yeah.
Let us
like
proceed.
To see you try.
You could probably actually break my legs, though.
Well, that's because you said.
A barbarian. What would that be? Unskilled strength?
Yeah.
Let's not roll it. Let's just go.
Please. Let us proceed on the mission.
Strength save 11. Ah. Okay, that's how we do that. Yeah, let's head out.
All right. You begin to gather your things. Backpacks, weapons, the like. The kobolds bid you farewell, and the chief himself in his blue garb and his blue dragon fang staff walks along and says to you, just as you're leaving, just as you're almost out of earshot, "Oh, and watch out for snakes. There's a lot of snakes around here."
We've noticed, but thank you for your advice.
Can I roll survival to avoid snakes?
I think that's more of a perception.
Yeah, that's perception. The snakes are very Ooh. Well
hidden. I did not avoid the snakes. I openly found the snakes.
War scanner is on fully.
I have +4 on perception, too.
War scanner is fully online. I will detect any snakes that come in range.
Balthazar is just going to walk.
So how many snakes did I accidentally find, Ben?
You mean how many snakes found you?
Yeah, how about that?
I believe all of them in the entire jungle.
All of them.
So the basilisk found us too.
Yep, basilisk. All right,
let's speed up and keep on going. I can cast Long Strider on the donkeys if we need to.
The donkeys can't come with it. It's too.
Set up. I forgot.
It's too.
I gotta avoid these snakes.
Solid snake found you.
If Solid Snake found me, we're all dead, dude. He's got a gun.
And he knows CQB.
He will not last against the war machine.
I mean, his
war
whole
machine's for a living.
I was about to say, his whole story plot is to destroy giant robots.
But yeah, the robots like do not have advantage. The mind of a human.
I feel like Snake might have advantage on Warforged.
I think he would. All constructs he would have advantage on. All attack rolls.
But he would not be able to handle my magic.
He would just shoot you in an RPG. And then he would cheat and do like what everyone else did and put it away and pull it out real quick, and then it's right reloaded again. Is it dead, Lily? Yeah, your iPad's dead, Lily. Here. You can have my phone. It's black. There you go.
That
Here's you some Mickey Mouse. So what do we see along the way, Ben?
All right. You begin your trek down the river path. The mud is thick and difficult to get through sometimes, but you finally found a decent stride, letting Yoru lead the way. Though, as he's explaining to you about the dangers of not being careful of serpents.
Dexterity saving throw? To dodge a snake that's obviously about to attack me?
He leans on a tree and says,
"The worst don't thing do this you can do is bang on a tree that a snake can be in."
Is roll poorly on initiative.
Oh god, flying snakes. That's a lot of flying snakes.
As from out of the bushes, treetops, the water, and the grass, several winged serpents flick their colorful feathers into the air and lift from the ground, ready to strike you.
Initiating battle. Shit. Initiating battle mode.
But if I get initiative, I got an advantage on initiative, you just want me to roll it twice, right?
Yep. Roll twice.
Ooh, 20!
Where is initiative?
I'll be right back.
Where's the initiative button?
Core page between armor class and speed.
Hey, you're so right. At least I'm not last. Let's see what the snakes get. 13. Hey, so the snakes are last.
Basically. Yeah, they don't have an actual they don't have an actual initiative thing, so I rolled dex. That's the same. It's the same thing.
Dexterity.
Yoru, you have woken up the snakes, and they are especially trained on you. But you're first. What are you going to do?
He said he'd be right back.
Oh, gosh darn it. Really?
Mm-hmm.
I'm back.
All right, what are you going to do?
Speaking of which.
You're looking at a snake right in your face.
It's actually like 10 feet away from you.
Yeah, that is like 10 feet away. I will consider. Should I roll something or?
Well, I mean, it's just surprising, so it feels like it's more in your face. Regardless, okay. Roll something. Well, what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna just go ahead and back away just a bit. How do I do the tracker, Ben? Like where it'll tell me how much my speed is at. So you know the path I'm taking.
You drag it and you hold space, or you push space.
Like that?
Like you're
did I do that right?
Like your dragon.
Oh, I think I did it. Kinda. I'll just go. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot that bow. Bang. God.
You take aim at the serpent as it flings itself from the branches of the tree. Let your arrow loose and clip its wings. The snake falters, tumbles to the ground, and stops moving. Bowser, your turn.
All right, so let's see.
At least three serpents are swimming towards you. They flap their wings, not so much to fly, but simply to, you know, get the water off of them. But they are heading towards you. You can tell they got their eyes trained on you.
On me?
Yep. What are you gonna do?
I move up a couple, 10 feet, and I throw a javelin at number 7.
All right. You take the javelin in hand and hoist
it. And I miss.
The snake quickly darts out of the way, curving to the left, and then resumes its slithering course across the water, gliding as if it were, you know, just on land as much as anywhere else.
All right, and I guess that's it. I get my Kopesh out, along with, you know, I already have my shield out.
Allie. What will you do? Water is about, it dips off pretty quickly, for about 3 feet out, halfway through the square, it's leg deep, but then as you get a little further out, it just drops off. Like, you can move into the square immediately below you, but you could not move any further. Then it would drop down to, like, 5 feet or more. Likes water. You slip into the water, stand still at the ready, and then as you approach the snake, it bares its fangs, but you smack it with a quick palm strike, breaking its wings, and it flops over into the water, dead.
Look, if we're about to start up a band, we're going to be called the Snake Punchers.
Anything else, Allie? War, you're up.
Accessing weapons. Scanning for targets.
I get it, Matt. Mm. Palm strike. It's funny. Because she has paws. That's funny, Matt. You're funny.
Targeting snake 5. Cannon activate. Thunder cannon fire.
Take it. Your thunder cannon. The lead bullet flings forward, pops both wings off the snake, and sends it into the lake. Bottom up.
Reloading. End turn.
Slither quickly towards you. One swoops dangerously close.
Ben, where did Matt go?
Where'd Matt go?
Yeah.
I'm still here.
Yeah, he's just muting his mic.
I have my mic muted. Oh. Yeah, can y'all hear the background sound, noise, music, whatever?
Yeah, I can hear some stuff, yeah.
Yeah, Lily's watching stuff on YouTube on my phone, and it's loud as shit.
Wish I had a lightning javelin to throw in the water right now.
Right, or if I had a lightning breath weapon, that'd be great. Yeah,
right?
Allie, a serpent swoops down against you, fangs bared, and takes a quick nibble. Though it tries, the bite barely misses you, just marginally scraping against your clothing.
Is that just poison damage?
Yeah.
I thought that their bite was also one physical piercing.
It is, but it looks like they didn't put that in there.
Oh, it's right out of the compendium. What the shit? Alright. Fuck them.
Close enough.
Yep. It is a lot of snakes.
Likewise.
Are all of the snakes going after the cat?
Yep. I mean, the cat's the closest. And she just pawed the snake to death.
That is true.
I mean, I threw a stick at it.
Colorful.
I have cure wounds.
Emblazoned and deals 6 poison damage to you. As it swoops back away.
Ooh. This is gonna be fucking... Ooh! Oh.
Another one swoops in, missing.
Whoa, I didn't even see that one.
Another one swoops in, biting you on the arm. You feel a weakness in your arm as you see a dark purple discoloration peering from beneath your fur from where the bite took place.
How much HP does she have?
Not a whole lot.
Yeah, she just... She's getting,
I mean, that would be putting me close to down, yeah.
You're only dead if you have, if you take enough damage to drop you to your hit point value and negative hit points. Yeah, you're not dead yet. You are dying.
Well,
you are not
doing
good.
She's also drowning.
Nah, she's not that deep in the water yet.
I mean, it takes 6 inches for a human to drown.
Yoru. Yeah, you never, like, officially go below zero, so you're at zero, Allie.
Yeah, this is way better than 3.5, Kip. You're good. You're not dead.
Yeah, right.
You're not dead.
This is 3.5, you'd be dead.
Yeah,
you're just unconscious.
3.5, you would be dead. Yoru,
nah,
what are you doing?
Negative 10 is death in 3.5.
Yeah, you're up, Yoru. What you gonna do?
Oh, shit, I'm Yoru. Right.
Yeah, you're Yoru. You're the crushed fang.
I'll just go ahead and...
I hate these sweeping ones that fly in and out.
I guess I'll use... Cure Wounds... On Alunai.
Save her. You quickly rush through the leafy foliage. Bend down, whisper a few words, and gently brush against her. Allie.
Boom. Ready to get 3 HP from me rolling a 1?
Five. You rolled it.
Honestly,
a 3.
Like. Alright.
Allie, you feel the poison leave your body.
Oh, he only went down because it crit him. I didn't even notice that. That's a lot of poison damage.
Yeah, the poison sizzles, and the coloration in your body goes back to the more than ordinary color you're used to being.
Yeah, blue.
Not dead purple.
Okay, so this water in the middle square, how deep is that?
I think, well...
Because I'm 7 feet tall.
You said it was leg deep for... Alan and I, but for you, that'd probably So, I don't know. Let God decide. And,
I mean, my turn's over, anything else, so. Can you?
Yeah, that's full action, so.
Bowser,
I'm
you're
all
up.
Good. Don't die on us, Kim. You got this, man. You're the damage dealer. Solo the game.
Yeah, she's not drowning or anything.
So, Ben, how deep's the water in the middle?
How deep's the water in the middle?
Yes. I'm 7 feet tall. Can I walk across it? No problem.
Yes, the water is not... The water, this is still fairly early on in the river. So
okay,
it's not
so...
super deep. It's about 5 feet deep. So you would be about 2 feet over the water.
Okay, I move here. And I dragon breath on 10, 9, and 8.
Alrighty.
DC 12 save.
The first one is engulfed in your flames. The second one, all the feathers on its wings flare in a bright burning blaze, and then all that's left are charred bone and flesh. And the third?
Passes. Let's see. It's a full action, isn't it?
I thought the breath was a bonus.
Or is it a bonus?
Ah!
Hell yeah, that's cool as shit. So, Ben, is it a bonus?
No, it's a standard.
It is? Okay.
Ben, did you get premium also, or is it because
yeah,
I'm in the game?
I upgraded to pro, so I'd have more room to put in maps and stuff, because I ran out, and I don't want to delete stuff.
Right? That's what I did.
Alright, and I just end my turn there in the water. Balthazar trudges across the water, determined, eyes glowing a bright red. Takes
so
a deep breath in.
Dodged? Oh no, there was three that he hit. Sorry, never mind, keep going.
And blew out a bright white flame from his mouth.
The white flames engulfed the serpents. Only one remains, and it is barely alive, severely burned, and angry.
Yep. It's like Matt made us lunch.
Allie, you're up.
I mean, I was gonna eat one, burnt or not.
What will you do? Which is hopefully not die.
With flurry of blows, can target more than one enemy, right? Or is it one enemy flurry of blows?
Have you tried clicking on it first?
Yeah, you can move your decide how you can divvy up how you want to use your attacks on flurry of blows.
So if he moved between those two snakes, he could actually attack both, right?
Yeah, if he wanted.
If he just moved one square to the left, he could hit them both.
He can't move his token right now. Hold on, let me move mine out of the way.
Alright, try now. Can you move her now? Try refreshing your page if it doesn't work.
So I went with white fire just because that was the first thing that popped in my head and that'd be the coolest.
Yeah.
It's different. Sort of.
Is it disgusting that I just ate 6 Reese's Cups? Like the full-size ones?
No, it's not at all. It'd be a little bit more disgusting if you ate 6 pounds of Reese's in one sitting. But then I would probably just be impressed and happy for you.
I've eaten 2 pounds of Snickers bar in one sitting.
I'm jealous.
Although that didn't stay in my stomach. That kind of went everywhere.
You are so... I can't hardly hear you when you talk.
Yeah, it's because I keep moving my mic away from my face because I don't trust myself to not chew gum too loud.
I mean, I can... Okay. I'm good. Okay, hold on. I'll be right back.
Alright, now that he's gone, guys, let's talk shit.
There you go.
I hath returned.
Looks like so is Yoshi. Let's see.
This chair is just not as comfortable as it used to be.
You wade through the water, now wet, and feeling terrible because a whole bunch of snakes just pump you full of venom. Kind of shake the water off and snap into a stance. Which one of these snakes are you punching first?
Punch the shit out of those snakes.
Punch. Punch.
Oh my god, that hurt. Can monks also make a second attack with a bonus action with their offhand fist, or is it just the three total with flurry of blows?
Oh, well, they get extra attack at fifth level, so they can do two for the standard, and flurry of blows is always two unarmed attacks.
Right, but it adds two more to the one they can make, right? Is it a bonus action to use flurry of blow? Is what I'm asking.
Yeah, it's a bonus action for two attacks for flurry of blows.
Right. So, but as a bonus action, can you also punch with your other fist?
Oh, sure. Why not?
I mean, the whole point of flurry of blows was originally you're using multiple limbs to deal your damage.
Right.
So yeah, I mean, it's just alternating however you want it.
Roll it.
Yeah, you're good. I'm just discussing, Cap. You're good.
You're just disgusting is more like it.
You're a fucking dick, Matt.
Thank you. That's what all my coworkers call me. At least that's my nickname at work.
All right, your first strike. The snake skews around it, flapping just out of the way, and is almost encircling around your arm as you pull it back. But your second strike lands true onto the lower serpent. I'm assuming the lower serpent. Breaking its face with one quick whack. As you whip back around to face this top snake, you slip in some mud and barely just narrowly miss the next snake. Anything else? I don't think you could do anything else. I mean, you could move, but you wouldn't want to provoke an opportunity attack. I mean, unless you just wanted to. The serpent's colorful and angry hiss. War! Bring it on, war! What will you do?
Calculating movement. Threat to ally is noted. Double threat. Question is, do I aim for the one near Balthazar, or do I try to assist Delani and take out the one she missed, or do I take out the one that is furthest away and just make sure its reign is tough decision. Probability of calculating. System movement.
Assuming direct control.
All your base are belong to us.
Launching attack. Beware of loud sound.
Ready. And
attack missed.
Flips around and looks quickly at the noise of the impact, as if something, you know, I mean, sudden. There's a sudden noise behind it and it reacts, but without anything there, it turns its attention back to the rest of you. Anything?
Reloading. End turn.
One flying snake zips around and takes a bite at War. It jams its fangs into you, and the poison seeps into the wooden portions of your body.
Damaged.
And before you can do anything, it darts back away.
Come back here.
The serpent that you were striking at returns it returns a bite at you, but quickly missing, zips away again, wraps around a tree branch, and flares up its wings threateningly as it hisses.
Balshers, it's like a cobra with wings.
Yeah, basically. The remaining serpents turn their attention to Balshazar. One swoops in and gives you a bite, missing, only scraping its narrow fangs against your armor.
I just move.
Scales.
What's armor?
The second one, likewise, nips at you, finds flesh, and injects you with poison.
Ouch.
You too, where you were bitten, feel the flesh deadening and see it go purple as it darts away again. Yoru, you're up.
So the others flew away. So you said the snake, too, wrapped around a branch, right?
Yep.
Like, how high up is that branch?
High enough for you to see it plainly. Well, it's... Yeah, it's in plain sight. It's looking as threatening as it can.
But is it high enough to be punched by, Alan?
Yeah, it's about, 5 feet off the ground, basically.
Alright, then I'm gonna trust that he can take care of that one, and I'm gonna try and take out one of the other two.
Alright.
So I'll go ahead and target Snake 7 with an arrow. Sounds well?
Roll it.
Boom.
You whip around and fire another arrow. It races over Balshazar's head and stabs the snake right between the wings as it falls down, and the impact kills it.
I light it on fire as it's going for flavor.
On a rock, head broken, body beyond repair.
Good. Fuck that snake. Then I'm gonna move. So am I doing that measure thing right, Ben, or what? Because I can't see it on my screen at all.
Well,
you click, and then you hit space. You hold, you left click and hold, and then you hit space.
And it'll.
And then every time you want to move a different direction, you hit space again.
Oh, I don't know what I just did.
How's it going? Hanging in there.
Your turn, Balshazar.
All right, my
floating around.
Did my javelin I threw earlier just completely disappear down the river, or was it heavy enough to sink to the bottom?
I'll let you, as a bonus action, check around real quick.
Alright, well, I move one square, do that. What kind of roll do I need to make?
Roll perception.
Jesus, where's that at?
Yeah, you find it. It's stuck deeper into the mud, and you almost trip over it, actually, but you find it, and you yank it out of the water.
I stow it real quick, and then, move one more, and attack numero 8. With my long sword. With a miss.
You swipe at it, but the snake has in a spectacular circular, almost screw-like fashion, it kind of barrel rolls around, just an aerial mass faster as it just dodges your strike and hisses at you threateningly. Allie. All
right.
Dart forward, eyes fixed on that snake. Your cat-like pupils narrow and become more feral as you rush forward, leap into the air, and with your clawed hands, cleave the wings off the snake along with its head. One fell swoop, dead.
Punching snakes to death is so cool. And I love snakes.
That would be such a metal band, too.
Punching snakes. I always thought that if I had a band, I'd name it Horse Puncher.
Are you going to do anything else, Allie?
I prefer calling her Alan. I think that works.
I have the feeling that Balzajar will be able to handle the snake keys and can handle them, so I shall go for the one that's a little further away. So let's see here. I shall... move here. And launch an attack. Take aim with me, Great Thunder Cannon, and blast it out of the sky! Kaboom!
You raise your weapon, you feel, literally, you feel the gears in it shifting and clanking, and you feel the power building up, the arcane energy, before finally, boom, you launch the bullet towards the serpent. And let's see, which one were you aiming for, number two?
Number two.
The second snake. Pow, like, there's not even... The wings flutter down like leaves in the air. As this snake is... It's in pieces.
Reload. End turn.
How do you delete some of the... Oh, go ahead.
The snake snaps at you quickly.
Hit.
Ooh. 8 poison damage. And it zips away.
I don't get any opportunity attacks.
Nope.
Gay. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, they got a fly speed of 60.
I mean, they're flying. Flying speed is almost always huge.
Yoru.
Is the snake trying to flee, or...?
It's hard to tell. Roll a nature check.
Whew! I might actually be able to do good on this one.
No, you won't. Oh, hey, look at you.
You recognize that the serpent is clearly frightened. It has been angered, and it is mostly trying to flee at this point.
I'm not taking any fucking chances.
You've been making tons of noise. You have been murdering the other snakes. It's not that smart, but it's recognizing that its allies are falling.
Shoot it. Kill it anyways.
Yeah, let's just take it out. Boom.
Because then bigger snakes will come.
Can I see it perfectly fine from here, or is the tree in the way?
The tree... Let's take a look. Yeah, you can kind of see it. I mean, it's a big... It's hard to miss the big, colorful wing.
All right, let's go for it. Woo! In the initial encounter. Boom. Fucking. I kill the snake before it can go talk to Snake Dad. Also, yeah. I'd like to apologize for being the one for causing this fight and being the only one who didn't take damage. So, that's on me.
Quick question. On the attacks and spellcasting tab, how do we get rid of excess things that are open?
What do you mean?
There's two. I have, like, for whatever reason, there's two blank ones.
If you click the lock, you can delete the blank ones.
You're a god. Thank you. That's the only thing I didn't try. I'm sorry, I'm a little special.
Battle complete.
Do the snakes have any gold?
No, but
I'll let you know.
I take their bodies with me.
As
the ones that are
looking over them, you do notice something strange about them.
They have parakeet wings?
Other than the fact that they have parakeet wings, some
other
of them
than that.
Have collars.
Ooh. I take the collars and the bodies. I mean, we gotta have food somewhere.
The collars are exquisite gold.
What size are these?
What size are these?
Are they small?
Oh, they're
like specific size.
The collars are tight enough that they could wrap around the snake. A snake.
No, I mean, like, what are the actual sizes of the snakes? I don't remember.
They're
are
tiny.
They small, medium? Damn it. All right. Fuck it. So let's examine those collars. Should I roll something?
No, I don't think so.
I collect all their bodies.
Well, that depends on what you want to try and know from them.
I guess, like, what they're made out of, what they could be. I try and read them, maybe, if there's anything written on them.
Alright, roll history.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, wow. Apparently, I kinda know about snakes.
I mean, you're part lizard.
So, it'll take you a minute to kind of observe them. Are you going to just take a short rest here, or what?
Yeah, we can just take a short rest here.
Alright.
Unless y'all want to do something else. I mean, we can't really go any further because Allie's about to die again. And by again, I mean she never really got above 3 HP. No hating. Let's see. Balshir Shaw.
You observe. And I mean, you all get to rest. If anyone has any healing potions, they can use them now.
Fucking, are you serious?
Ooh, you didn't gain much.
Plus 3. Well, I'm not bloodied anymore. Well, I wasn't really bloodied to begin with, I don't think.
Yeah, guys, I kind of really fucking screwed the pooch there, huh? That was all me.
I'll take a mouse.
I give Matt a mouse. How many mice do I have left? I've eaten 3, and I gave 2 to the kobolds. 1 to Matt. How big
and one
was
to Yeah.
How big was this bag of mice?
This bag of mice was fairly big. It was about 50 mice in there.
Holy shit, that's a lot of mice.
One, a whole lot.
Bastard dangles it over his face and breathes some fire on it to roast it real quick.
Have any of the mice eaten each other? Because they tend to do that. I'm pretty much asking
no,
how much I have left.
In fact, you're kind of surprised that you might actually have more mice than you began with.
Okay, that's perfect. All right, I continue.
Now, well,
so
yeah,
Jake, is that what
resting,
you do for all of your snakes? I'll take first watch.
I mean, it's only an hour. I mean, you're not doing anything especially strenuous, but,
Now, let's see where the son of a bitch go. Just, look for anything out of the ordinary. After I've already collected all these snakes and threw them into a pile.
As you're collecting the snakes and you're resting, you start to hear, you could have sworn that you've been hearing an occasional growl, but it was so soft and so innocuous.
I just thought it was the cat.
You could have thought it was... I mean, you might have thought it was the cat. You might have even thought it was your own stomach.
Won't be after we finish these snakes.
But nothing appears to be approaching you so far.
I alert the others. Keep your eyes open and your ears... keen? Your ears open and your eyes keen? I don't know. Something like that. Something, you know. There's something growling around us. I'm not sure if it's a thing or my stomach, but let's just keep a watch.
Scanning.
I guess I'm going to go for a swim because, you know, I'm kind of a lizard, so.
Oh, you're also trying to rinse off the collars while you're there?
The schwann?
Yeah.
Because, yeah, there's you know, gore on them.
I guess I'm kind of looking at them underwater. Lizards.
How many?
Lizard folk are 15-minute breath, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
And we have 11, I think. 10 snake collars?
Yes, I can hold my breath underwater for 15 minutes.
Yeah, you're underwater, and as you are underwater and examining these, you know, the noise dies away as you dive into the depths of the river, and you just focus and you just examine and contemplate. Where have you seen this before? You could have sworn you know the markings, the serpentine markings, because there are serpentine markings, specifically serpents, on these little collars. And then it hits you. You're pretty sure these belong to some Yuan Tai.
Aw, shit.
Oh, fuck.
We need to get out of here.
Yeah, and typically, they don't leave their pets alone for long. But as you are underwater and you're examining this, and as you are resting, you start to feel some current change in the water, some movement. And it's not your own.
Oh wait, I feel it in the water?
Yep, you feel something moving around in the water.
Then I get, I guess perception to look around for it?
I get out of the water should be your first instinct.
I mean, I've got a pretty high perception.
Peering through the rippling water, you see another pair of eyes looking back at you.
Whew.
And they're not lizard folk eyes.
It's a shark.
Can I tell what kind of eyes they are?
Roll nature.
Nature? Oh shit, is there a fucking alligator or is it another goddamn snake? Ooh!
Look at you!
There we go. See, I'm
using
right
your ranger skills. See, that's how most of my characters are.
See, I also went with like, which background was it? Outlander? So, you know, out of all of the skills I could pick from, I didn't end up with one of them. Because lizard folk got to choose from, like, the same skills that rangers get, and same with Outlander, so I just didn't get investigation.
Yeah, okay.
You glance around, and immediately realize what you're looking at. You're looking at what you were sent here for.
Oh, it's the drake.
It's a drink.
Oh, and $5. It's the another pet of the Yuan-ti.
You don't see any collars or anything on it, though it's a little hard to tell even... Well, actually, it's not too hard to tell. You see, there's no collars on it. It seems like a wild animal. But draconic related all the same.
So I'm definitely going to get out of the water. I lean my head up and yell, oh fuck, I guess. Get down.
Ah, fuck! Bowser snaps to attention. Walks over and... What's going on?
I point at the water and say, there.
And
can they
the
see
water.
It in the water, or is it too deep?
Oh, they see something peering at them from the water. It kind of followed you. It's peeking its eyes up. Yeah, you don't have to roll perception too hard.
All right.
Where? I don't see it! Oh, it's a little bitty baby drake.
It's kind of cute.
It is kind of cute, but it's probably the size of a pony. Oh, there we go.
Oh,
that
no,
makes better
that's
sense.
That's not a pony.
That's a horse. Do I have my dragon breath back?
Immediately. In fact, she notices that it's not alone.
Oh, is there more fucking flying snakes?
No, there's not flying snakes, but she
it's another
absolutely
drake.
Hear water splashing from further back as it. She glances around some of the brush and sees more drake heads peeking out of the lake or the river.
Well, let's kill them all, best we can.
All right. So, should we roll initiative, or?
Yeah, absolutely. Let me clear out the initiative.
All right, this is... Oh, so now there are two baby drakes. Drakelings.
Oh, no, they're all the same size. I just didn't adjust them.
Ah, shit. All right, let's do this, guys.
Did you see the initiative I just rolled, or do I need to redo it, since it says you wanted to send this result, and it didn't... Send it because I didn't.
You can have the 15.
Okay.
It's because you didn't click your token. I was wrong. You do need to click your tokens in this. Whew. Let's hope I can beat that 18. Yeet.
Someone's gonna have to put me in the tracker though.
I got you. What did you have?
A 15.
He had a 15.
Ah, there you
already
go.
Got it.
Yeah, you got it.
Hey, I'm last this time. No, I'm not.
Look at that dexterity saving throw you just did for a crocodile. I don't think I didn't notice that, Ben.
I was about to point it out, too. Don't feel bad.
Are they dracodiles?
Well, they do look like they're certainly related to a dragon, and they don't look like crocodiles at all.
So these guys are large, right?
Yes, they are.
Can I tame it and ride it?
You can try.
Damn straight.
But it's Adley's turn first. Oh, you said you got all the snakes and threw them in a pile, right?
Yeah, they're behind me. I put them over here.
Size-wise, how big is this pile of dead snakes?
Well, they're all about, let's see, a tiny creature would probably weigh, what, 3 pounds, 4 pounds? Or am I thinking that's diminutive? No, diminutive's like a fly. Tiny's like a house cat.
Yeah, tiny's like a house cat.
A house cat or a small dog. So
there is 10 of them. 10 house cats stacked on top of each other, pretty much.
Pretty much.
What you doing, Allie?
She's gonna go get eaten, is what she's doing.
The drake growls at you. Oh, gosh. Whack, 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 whack. All three of your strikes connect.
Wow, Drake's AC is how low?
It's 10 AC according to the entry.
Oh, man. Okay.
Actually, it's 12. I don't know why it's not doing that right.
Still, though.
Yeah, either way, she hit it with each and every strike. You lunge forward, claws bared, and make a mix of palm thrusts, cat claws, and, you know, just otherwise violent martial arts moves.
Well, so are dragons, but they're, you know...
Remind me not to piss off that cat.
Yeah, it's not really all about dodging, though.
It thrashes
like
in the water angrily.
Weak points, essentially.
It splashes left and right and up and down, and it's causing a gigantic ruckus. It roars a peculiar dragon roar. It doesn't sound quite
man.
Like, it sounds almost like it's gurgling.
You really got that one.
Yoru!
I'm gonna go ahead and, Hunter's Mark is just a bonus action, right?
That is correct.
I'm going to cast that on Drake, too. I'm going to cast it and set him as my target, so...
Alright.
And then I'm going to go ahead and shoot my bow.
Roll it.
Boom. And... boom.
You lean back, your bow not take aim at the creature peering at you from the water. The arrow streaks through the air and lands into the neck of the gator, or not gator, the drake. Blood starts to fill the water, even more so than when the snakes were there. Anything else?
I'll move forward some. Boom.
Belshazzar.
Okay, so let's see. And I attack Drake 1 with my my sword of stabbing. Not really, it's more of a sword of slashing.
You hunker over, raise your sword against the creature that is...
I cut its head off.
Yeah, you chop its head right off. One clean...
And I quickly grab it and throw it on land so we don't lose it.
Alright, roll strength.
Oh shit.
Yeah, man, way to KS, bro.
It's... Well, I mean, how many HP does this person have left? Where's the strength save? How do I do that?
Are you proficient in strength saves?
Yes.
You know what? Go ahead and
Go ahead. There we go.
Yeah, you yank that thing up.
Uh-oh. Well, all right. It is not kill stealing. It's focus saving, firing. Yeah. I don't know how many D12s this thing dealt in one hit. I mean, I'm done. My brother's been known to kill people, total party kills in the first encounter, so I don't take chances.
I don't put that past Ben.
It's happened like twice.
Ben is the demigod of D&D.
He's more like Anubis.
Ben the Unbreakable. Or his heart shall show no movement.
The second drake swims towards you, fangs bared. It's actually a slow swimmer. It only has 20 speed, so it swims right up to you, and it's just... snap. You know, it's just snapping at you. The other one, on the other hand...
There's a third?
Yeah,
oh god, it's behind us! Sorry, that's where my initiative tracker is.
Or out of the water.
I guess I'll move to the other corner. Let me guess, there's going to be another one coming up there.
War, what are you doing?
Getting in the water. No.
I'm sensing the one that's approaching, turning like a literal turret, taking aim with my cannon, and taking a shot at it.
Roll it.
I'll just move one over here. And just take aim and a fire. Kaboom.
You fire your cannon. And blast it, a big chunk out of its, it's actually now missing its hind, right leg, as it snarls at you angrily.
Oh, I keep forgetting that I'm supposed to have advantage on people who haven't attacked yet. Oops.
Allie, what are you doing? You're basically a tiger. You maul the thing to death.
What? My thumb? Daddy's phone's almost dead, but here.
Ooh, it's starting to float down river, Matt.
Can I use a reaction to pull it up?
Alright. Try and roll another one, then.
Nope.
Nope.
Oh, shit.
Can I just at least keep it from flowing down?
Unless Allie wants to try and go get it.
I mean, my swim speed's pretty high, so I could probably go for it.
Yeah, you got this. If you want to go get that thing, I'll take out Drake 3.
Yeah, I mean, it's close to dead. I'll definitely swim for it.
All right.
How fast would you say it's moving down river, Ben?
It's going fairly steadily, about 20 feet per round.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go for it on my turn. You guys can take care of this thing. So, Cap, if you want to, oh, his turn's over, so.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Flurry of blows, and he hasn't moved anywhere else, so.
Yoru, crushed fang.
What would my action be to try and grab it? Would that be a bonus action, or would that be a full action?
Since it's an object now, you get one free interaction with an object per turn.
So I can shoot at it before I go for it, or what? That's pretty much all I'm asking.
Can you shoot before you go for it?
I mean, if it's just a bonus action, that just means I can't transfer my Hunter's Mark this turn.
Yeah, you can... Well, let's see. Yeah, you can shoot and then go. It is a bonus action.
When you're
not doing anything else.
It just means I can't transfer Hunter's Mark, because Hunter's Mark is a bonus action to transfer, right?
Yeah, that is correct.
Alright, boom. Oh, wow. Why did I even bother? That was not a very good roll. Okay. But yeah, let's go and swim for it.
And then, basically, since the current is going... Water,
and you get a hold of it.
And I'm making a...
Just push it straight as hard as you can.
Yeah, you can try and... You can make an athletics check. An athletics check to kind of push it towards the bank. Or, you know, just pull it somewhere. The river is going towards the left.
So I should make an athletics check?
Yeah, just make an athletics check.
Alright, boom.
And I would say to push it as hard as you can onto that bank immediately to the left, because that's the way the water's flowing.
Yeah, you manage to push it over to the bank, and you're in the water. You got it on the riverbank. It's relatively secure.
Okay, cool beans. I'm all good. I'm done.
And it does indeed look like it's a wild creature. It has, now that you're, you know, up close to it, it has nothing on it other than, you know,
scars.
Scars, and, you know, it's pouring out blood out of, you know, everywhere.
Okay, what kind of action is a charge in this game? Do you get a +1 still, or?
They may charge a feat.
Oh, that's gay.
I wasn't lying to you, Matt.
Well, I was just making sure.
Though,
I trust
you can use the push attack in place of any of your normal attacks that you would make if you're taking specifically the attack action.
Nah, I'm just going to move over here and use a... Oh, where'd it go? It's that savage reckless attack. That's what it is.
Roll it.
Are you shitting me?
Well... You're more reckless than advantageous in this swing at it. You raise it high, and the gator, rather than leaping out of the way, it tucks in its legs and rolls, dodging your blow. Lands back on its feet, mouth snaps open, and it lunges for you.
Do a barrel roll. All right, I end.
Yeah, it is lunging for you. And you're granting it advantage, aren't you? Because of
Because I was banking on rolling, you know, at least a 15. Hello?
Yeah, I hear you. Hang on.
Okay.
For crying out loud, the thing is not working.
In 3 seconds, we're going to get 50 rolls.
I'll be right back, guys.
Alrighty. That's a miss. He's getting two.
He has advantage on you, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah, that's right. Dirt, he hits.
The maw opens wide and it leaps forward, snaps onto you, and rustles you around on dry land, dealing...
Don't die on us, Matt.
10 damage.
Ooh.
You are now also grappled by it.
Matt, have you even raged yet?
No, I haven't.
Come on, bro.
I mean, it's... I didn't know how far into the game we were going to go today. I didn't know we'd come on to these drakes immediately.
Are rages short rest or long rest that they recover?
Long rest.
Yeah. Oh,
then that's fair. All right.
And I only get 3, so I thought, you know, it was going to be a longer day than this.
Gun's turn. He said he's away, right?
I'm here.
Oh, here. Yeah, it's your turn. Your dragon companion has just gotten snapped up by a gator, and it is flinging him up into the air in its jaws, just...
If I wasn't so close to dying, I'd do an animal... An animal handling. Let me go!
In the jaws of the gator, just or of the drake.
Should I do anything special, or should I just go for an attack?
Punch the shit out of it.
You can attack it whatever you want. If you wanna strike it, then you go right ahead.
I'm going for a hand axe. Attack.
Your hand axe. You raise it, you wait for it to arc its head back towards you. You cleave into the skull of the drake.
Lose your axe.
It moans. And then collapses. Its jaws going loose, freeing Belshazzar. And slaying the drake.
We just need the heads of these for the kobolds, right?
Oh, no, I'm not just taking the heads, though.
Oh, well, I mean, I was going to use my artisan ability.
Oh, yeah, you can start harvest. If you want to just harvest them right now, you can go ahead and do that.
So, let's do another short rest.
So more drinks can come and eat us? There we go.
All right, so...
Or sighs and goes, that was reckless.
Then darts are dex scaling, right?
Darts. Yes.
Alright, so let's go ahead and I'm going to try and make some darts out of this drake.
And how long does it take you to do that?
It's one short rest for any smaller, larger creature.
Alright.
I get to roll 1d4 to make some.
Alright, roll it.
Oh. 2.
You harvest 2 darts from this particular drake.
It's tibia and fibia.
What are the rest of you doing during this rest, apart from, you know, just relaxing?
Well,
resting?
I'm piling
the 2 darts to Alan, so Alan has some ranged weapon.
Ah, that's not a bad idea.
I'm collecting all of the drake bodies. How heavy are these drakes?
Oh, they are like 500 pounds.
Do they float?
Well, yeah, they float reasonably well. As long as you can keep air in them.
War is making sure his ammo count stays high. He's, I think, short rest he gets regains 10 bullets per short rest.
Oh my god!
He does, yeah, that's an artifact.
That is
thing.
A lot of ammo!
It is.
And he gains 40 on the long rest.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of ammo.
So, here's my proposition to y'all. Wargun, you have those ogre strength bracers, right? Or gauntlets.
That is correct.
So, how about we rope all these drakes together and float them back down to the kobold village? They asked for heads, but let's go above and beyond and bring them whole bodies.
I can make arrangements.
I have rope if we need to tie them together.
Yeah, I do too.
Heads, do I?
I mean, everyone with some sort of pack.
Pretty sure all the packs come with rope.
Not all of them. I think Priest Pack doesn't. You would have to make me look up the book.
So what kind of roles do we need to do? Or can we just do that, Ben?
You can just do that, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, then let's just do that.
You gather the creatures together. You
if everyone's okay.
Are we even sure that the kobolds are downriver?
They are. You came from downriver.
Okay.
We came from the left?
Fuck yeah. What's
up? You came from the right.
The right? That's fine. It's still easier than dragging them on land.
So let's tie some drakes together and go boating. Let's do it. I like it.
I didn't say go boating.
So what are we doing? Are we dragging them?
So one person's on one side of the river, one person's on the other side of the river.
Oh, we're pulling them. That makes sense, yeah.
Yeah, and there's
that sounds
rope.
Great.
And
there you go.
One person is rolling perception.
Sure, I'll take it.
Or at least.
What's your perception? Mine's +4. Nope.
Mine was a 17, bitch. I need to turn that advantage off. Oh, where's those, UNTs or whatever.
You see one looking at you from in the bushes.
There are going to be a lot of corpses around here.
All right, I say let's start walking. Let's get out of here.
From in this little spot right there, or right around here, you, Belshazzar, above everybody else, just happen to glance over, you know, you're talking, you're kind of cutting up with everybody about how you've slain your first dragons, and you just kind of look over, oh man, that was, what's that over there? You see in the bushes a pair of yellow eyes with black slits staring at you.
I set the bushes on fire.
Don't do that yet. You don't want to start a war with the incredibly powerful snake people.
I wave at them. And alert the rest of the group.
Are you really just waving at them, or do you actually set the thing on fire?
Do they appear hostile?
So far, you can only see one.
It's a UNT. They're almost always hostile.
So what'd you say, Matt?
Group poll, there's four of us. Who thinks we should set it on fire?
I think we should at least see if it doesn't want to kill us first.
There's snakes. All these snakes around here
Who's
had collars.
Does anyone have persuasion?
I have intimidate.
I say we say the drakes killed the snakes.
Well, yeah, that was my first point, but what are we doing
here?
This
wasn't us. We killed the drakes for you guys who killed your snakes.
Why are some of these snakes on fire and smoldering?
Who's saying this?
Look.
Not me.
Can't explain why the drakes were able to breathe fire, Matt. Not our problem.
But there's a gold dragonborn standing right there with no shirt on. Which looks more likely to breathe fire? The All crocodile right, yeah. drakes or the dragonborn?
So, what is War's charisma, Casey?
Zero.
Well, we're not very charismatic.
I ain't talking.
Well, then I'll step forward since I'm the barbarian.
You are kind of the semi-leader of this group.
I'm the glue.
We have, like, the worst charisma ever. Mine's minus one. Caps is minus one. Casey's
actually, you know what? How about, rather than that, I just step forward and say, I can see you. Present yourself.
Oh. All right. These eyes narrow. And rather than stepping out clearly...
He shoots me with an arrow.
No, you see the humanoid figure scale around one of the trees and stands firmly on a branch. A woman, dark hair, of course, the yellow eyes.
Yeah.
You know, the cat eye, the slits, and the pupils. Green hooded, she looks at you and says, "Here I am. What are you doing with my pets?"
Depends on which ones are your pets.
It seems to me that you have taken the liberty of slaying them. Well, you aren't exactly in a place you should be now, are you? She says.
Were they in the right place either, though?
Roll insight to see if you can guess what they're doing.
Sure, I'll do it. Where is it?
She replies to Allie and says, "The places that try to kill you are usually the places to avoid."
But then they should have been here.
Such an inferior creature to know that.
Oh, shit. I rolled an 18. What are they doing here anyway?
You're guessing that since this area was so heavily guarded, I mean, they had their own snakes there specifically to guard this area. You've pieced together, basically. You got, like, a gut feeling. There is something important in this area.
If this area is so dangerous, then why are you here?
She says, "It's a surprise."
I don't like surprises. War takes a defensive stance with his weapon armed up.
She says to you, "Perhaps if you will relinquish the collars, we may go our separate ways."
Sure, I don't care.
You can have them.
But it's not, you know, what is Mr. Lizard Man thing, since he was the one that collected them all and risked his face to a drake for?
I mean, I think we got interrupted by the drake before I could fully determine what they were. Didn't I just kind of figure they were UNT?
No, you were pretty sure they're UNT. Like, you're now, like, if you weren't sure before...
Didn't we need the whole drakes?
So, the UNT don't want any of the drake, right? They just want the collars from the snakes?
Yeah, they want the collar. She wants the collars from the snakes.
That's fine.
Yeah,
I'm for giving up the collars just so we can take these full-bodied drakes back. Do they want the snakes back too?
Do you ask her that?
That's a good question. Well, your snakes are already dead, so we'll just take them with us too.
Oh, responding to Allie, she says, very well. Hang all the collars on the furthest branch of that tree, and she points to the branch closest to the one that War is standing towards.
I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back.
How do you respond?
She said put the collars on a tree.
Yeah, she pointed to the one closest to War. Like, hang them all on one branch, and she will collect them.
And what about these corpses? Yeah, come down here and get them yourself if you want them so bad.
She looks back to Allie and says, you have already put me out a great deal. The least you can do is place them on the branches.
Hello.
She's just silently, coldly looking at all of you.
I'll be right back, guys.
All right.
She stares at you, Belshazzar, or not Belshazzar. Oh wait. You said you'd collect them? Like, Allie's saying she'll put them on the branches. Or so. Who's doing what?
I mean, I'm not gonna take my eyes off her. I'm staring her down. I just kind of nod and say, let someone else put them on there.
All right. You collect the collars, one after another. It doesn't take long. You've got them all. Jake, do you hand over the one that you had? Because you were examining at least one. Alright. The tree is about 10 feet tall, but there is a lower branch.
Oh, I'll be right back real quick again.
It's about 7 feet up, so it's not much of a climb. Well, for a tabaxi, anyway.
Okay, I'm back.
As you do so, roll perception, Allie. Actually, everybody, roll perception. Twitch.
Okay, what I miss?
Ripples on the back of your neck as you shiver.
Do I need to roll a perception? Around.
Yes, you do.
Oh, no. Alright.
You get the sense that she isn't alone. But whoever it is that's looking at you, they're keeping their distance. What do you do? She looks at you with a bit of disdain and says, it is not for you to know.
I hope they don't have, like, some kind of mind control power by staring at you.
because I'm just glaring her down.
You want tea or snakes, Matt?
Sorry, that's just...
Come on, bro. Know your reptile lore.
She nods at all of you. And kind of motions with her head for you to leave. You know, she just kind of cocks it, you know, like one quick...
Alright, get out of here.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, get out.
So, I guess we finish tying the dregs together and start walking upstream.
Alright. As you are hoisting them away, roll another perception.
God dang it. They're following us, those sons of bitches.
Aw, shit.
Alright!
You get a short distance. And both Belshazzar and War, at just exactly the right moment, glance back and see that indeed you are being followed as you travel downriver. Allie, you do manage to see one of them shifting around in the bushes, but they're keeping their distance, but they are following you.
Are they following us hostily, or just like, does it seem like they have ill intent? Or are they just kind of scouting us?
Roll, if anyone wants to know about that, roll insight. Belshazzar, he gets the feeling that they're being stalked. Not so much just followed, but you're being stalked. Like a predator hunting prey.
War hums in suspicion. I have the feeling we're being followed for a reason. Reason unknown.
Let's see,
the kobold village is fast approaching.
I would say let's kind of pick up the pace, and who's the ranger, Yoru, Jake?
Starting a battle between the Yuan-Ti and kobolds is not a good idea.
It is not. That's why I also think the Yuan-Ti would be a bad... I think they would not want to do the same thing. They wouldn't want to fight the kobolds. So, I would think we'd be more safe still getting closer to them. I would say let's get there as quickly as we can with one person watching behind us at all times.
Alright, you...
One person watching behind, one watching the sides and the, I guess, a couple of... You know, just keeping a scout type.
A diamond formation of a
essentially,
scout.
Essentially. Someone watching forward, two people watching the sides, one watching back.
And Moore's probably probably in the front dragging, because he's got the ogre gauntlets. And he's probably dragging them.
Yeah, Warren Belshazzar, it'd be both of us. We're just pulling them up water.
I
think the ranged person needs to be watching behind us, Mr. Ranger. Sure.
I just roll another perception, or are we just going to keep going, or what?
I'd say let's... I don't know, Ben.
Well...
We see them behind us.
First of all, Allie, they do not respond to you. You can see them, but they're just... They're basically just staring at you from in the bushes. And they do not respond.
It'd be a bad idea to set like part of the woods behind us on fire, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Bad idea. Do not.
Because my idea was, you know, set the woods on fire and then they can't follow us.
Don't try it. Let them follow.
Yeah, so let's hightail it back to the village. What do you think, guys?
Oh, are you gonna try and lose them?
No, we still have these drakes. We're just going to have to cautiously keep going. We'd have to abandon them. That's the whole point we came out here.
Right. We're not going to abandon. We'll proceed as normal with a watchful eye.
What do you think, Jake?
They're Yuan Ti is all I can say. Like, they're crazy fucking evil.
This is true.
So for all we know, they're literally just trying to find out where we are, and then they're going to go and kill the kobolds too, so...
I don't think that they'd be strong enough to take out an entire village of kobolds. Not with us there. Well, we'll be there too. If this force was strong enough to kill us and an entire village of kobolds, then they were going to be able to do it anyways.
Do we know right. their intention? Like, are they hostile then?
He said that they just feel like that we're being stalked, like prey.
Hunted. As the word goes.
Then I say, yeah, let's just keep going. Hope for the best.
As you approach the Fangwielder tribe, you see that there are, there's actually a party going on. Basically. You roll up with your drakes, and there's a large bonfire. The kobolds are all dancing around it happily. There's food, and there's wine, and that, specifically wine, not some weird drink.
From actual wine.
Local drink, an actual wine. And the chief approaches you and says, "Oh, ho, what a day of celebration this is indeed. Four great drakes in one day," as he counts yours.
Four.
It's like, yes, four. You and our an offering from our recent visitors. And he points over to the woman you had been speaking to previously. And she glares at you as she walks from behind the throne and nods at you. And that is where we're going to call it for tonight.
All right.
Cool with me.
I do not trust these Yuan Ti.
I don't either. Like,
no way. not a Yuan Ti.
Our instincts are kicking in. We're like, no, bad.
If Neverwinter Nights taught me anything, it's that Yuan Ti should be bad. Fucking burning these things.
Right now. We shouldn't have gave them the chance, but... I mean, I'm just... Right now, when she walked around the corner, like, I heard... Bum, bum, bum! Just go off in my head.
Yeah, alright, so... Let's keep a close eye on the snake people.
Yeah. Maybe this is good for our... I don't know.
I definitely do not trust them.
I don't either. But that's not...
How much EXP did we get, bro?
Yeah, bro. The EXP bin.
Oh, yeah, the EXP. That is correct. I have entirely forgotten about that. Let's see.
I'm assuming we're at the exact amount of EXP needed to be at level 3.
No, we're at zero. What, why would you think that?
Yeah, you're at bare bones minimum for third level.
We wouldn't that's be at 100. Zero, Matt. We're level 3.
So that's the joke, Jake.
Damn it, Matt. It's so hard to tell when you're joking.
I'm sorry.
That would start us at 900 EXP. 900, I think, since we're level 3.
Yes, 900.
All right. Thank 900. You, KC. I mean, we probably each got, like, what, 5 EXP from the snakes? I mean, they're, like, 1/8 challenge.
Such a metagamer. Just let Ben give us the EXP he wants to give, because I would say that was a successful encounter also with the Yuan Ti, because we avoided combat and didn't have to kill them.
Did we, though? I mean, like I said, Yuan Ti, bro, they're coming back for us.
I didn't say we completely avoided it.
start tonight, you gain, each of you gains 150 XP.
So we're at 1,050?
Yep.
That's the golden.
1050.
Alright. So how'd you guys like tonight?
It's gonna be a fun game.
I liked killing those snakes. That was pretty awesome. Usually I don't like killing snakes.
Don't let your pets hear that.
You almost died. Yay.
I mean, I got pretty close to dying, too. I was at 10 HP at one point.
Alright, well, thanks for playing, and I guess we'll play again, let's see, Tuesday?
Tuesday!
Yes, it'd be Tuesday.
Tuesday.
I shall try to make it.
Well, I hope you should. You can. You're staring down, like, one snake person.
Yeah. All right, well, I'm gonna go do homework then.
All right.
All right.
See you later.
See ya.